Hey guys, it's Andrea, and today I have my new releases for you guys. I have them under the sheet of paper just so I could tell you about them real quick. They are Valentine's Day kind of sort of releases, and these will be up in the shop as of right now. And once they're sold out though. I have been trying to get the numbers as good as possible, so things have been staying in stock, which I'm really happy about. So let's get started. This week is Valentine's Day themed, as you can tell from my stack so far. And I will be doing a release next week as well. And next week is multicolor, which I'm going to give you guys a little sneaky peek right there. You see it? Sneaky peek, sneaky peek, sneaky peek. Do you see anything important? There is probably about another 15, maybe more things for next week. And another sneaky peek right there. So stay tuned for those next week. This week is Valentine's Day. I did do February releases last week, and if you guys got those or if you are planning on getting them, I definitely would. I think they are going to match a lot of the Valentine's Day spreads and colors that I have going on. So I'm going to show you guys what I have planned for today. So this is Love Glitter. It has the no formulated washi, which not all of them have because I just reformulated the washi recently, and these are all washi strips on here, and I made them like this so they are stackable if you guys didn't see in my last release video. Then I have the bottom washi, you have the full boxes, you have the ombre hard checklists, which I love the coloring in these, the headers, the little things, and then the full boxes there. And then the functional sheet on this one is the same as the more recent ones. And the quote on this one is there is only one happiness in life, to love and to be loved. And I thought that was really cute. And it turned out like really pretty. I actually, when designing this, I hated the colors of it. I felt like on the screen it looked different than it does in person. And I'm really happy with this overall. The next collection is actually a re-release, and we re-released pink and gray. It's a very, very light pastel, almost pink and peach and kind of like ivory color scheme, so it does look very like light, but you'll be able to see a little better in the pictures. So this is the headers, that's like a cream on the bottom. It's easier to see in person, and I think it's super pretty. You have the little things, and then you have the half boxes, the ombre heart checklists, the bottom washi, and then the functional. The regular washi will be restocked in the old format for this, as well as the full boxes. So those aren't technically new releases. This is an old kit, so this is just reformatted. And then the quote on this one says, believe in the beauty of your dreams, which I thought was really cute. So I wanted to keep these, like, yeah, they're Valentine's Day-y. This one's super Valentine's Day-y, but this one is kind of could be used anytime. And I know that I'm probably gonna be doing Valentine's Day spreads all through February. The last collection that's going to be released today is my personal wedding collection, which I actually spent a ton of time on doing this because I wanted it to be the same exact colors as my wedding, and I wanted it to really like match everything. If you guys have been following me as far as like wedding updates, my colors are blush, navy, and gold, and then I did this cream color, like an ivory color, just because that's a classic wedding color. So on here you have the little things. This has the like faux foil that's in our logo, and then we have our half boxes, the little things, the ombre boxes, and then I'll show you guys that one last. Then this one has the full boxes, the bottom washi, and then the reformatted washi strips, which stack. And then this, which is like super special to me, is the functional sheet, and this says to infinity and beyond. And I'm gonna go ahead and just adjust the exposure a little bit if I can. Actually, I'm not sure how to do that on here. Okay, so it says to infinity and beyond, which is like our like I guess slogan of our wedding. And then you have the gold foil weekend banner, which I threw in there. And I don't know, I just really like this. It's our wedding colors, and I'm using it at our wedding week. Even though our wedding week is technically Valentine's Day, I'm doing Valentine's Day spreads the rest of the month, and that is the infinity collection. And then last but not least, we did do three decorative sheets. And my thought process on these three decorative sheets is I was gonna do a sampler for Valentine's Day, but I wanted to give you guys a little bit more of options because I feel like a lot of people are doing Valentine's Day samplers. So what I wanted to do was do something that could easily match these kits as far as decorations. I feel like this one goes really well with this kit, or could go really well with the pink and gray because it has a little bit more of muted tones. But I do think that it could even go well with the glitter kit, but obviously this one was formatted for the glitter. But if you're not huge on glitter, but you want some glitter, you could definitely use this one with this as well. My other thought process of this is that I think that the February colors go really well with the, with kind of Valentine's Day. So I thought even if you had the monthly colors, which I'm gonna go ahead and lay out for you guys, you could definitely use, I might as well get that in frame. You could use any of these sheets with the monthly colors and you could get a really pretty spread. So maybe if you already have all the monthly colors and you only wanna pick up one or two of these, and maybe you don't wanna pick up the glitter one, but you still wanna do a Valentine's Day spread, you could still use all of your monthly items with these three sheets. They're sold individually and, get some Valentine's Day spreads or just overall like cute lovey-dovey spreads. I'm probably gonna do something similar for St. Patrick's Day and not do a full-on St. Patrick's Day set. Maybe something St. Patrick's Day-y, but not like 100% St. Patrick's Day-y. And then do some little cute sheets like these. These sheets, size-wise, are a little bigger than our little thing sheets. They feel a lot bigger, actually. And if you have a box sheet, they're pretty big. So I thought these were really cute and I tried to do something a little bit like over the top and then something a little bit more muted. I feel like with these two, you can use them other times than Valentine's Day. This one is cute. I mean, I like them all and I think that they go really well with the collections and I can't wait to do some Valentine's Day spreads with them. So let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Definitely check out the shop for all your Valentine's Day needs and I will talk to you guys in my next video. And don't forget that next week we are doing multicolor releases, which I'm super pumped about and I can't wait to use. So